Well, hey, everybody. This is Chris DeFurio with Keys to the Shop. Welcome to another edition of Shift Break. Today's episode is brought to you by the Ground Control Cyclops Brewer from Voga Coffee. The Ground Control Cyclops Brewer is revolutionizing batch brew coffee and more because the SCA award-winning technology and the award-winning design of this machine allow you to have unprecedented control over a variety of flavors that you might not have ever thought possible with your coffee. On top of being able to really level up your batch brew and create a real differentiation in your cafe with the quality of your coffee, this machine also allows you to brew tea, hot cocoa, batched iced lattes, batched cold brew. And this is an all-around workhorse, showpiece, and batch brew game changer all in one. So if you're looking to upgrade your quality, efficiency, and versatility, then I highly recommend that you check out the Ground Control Cyclops Brewer from Voga Coffee. Go find out more information at their website, vogacoffee.com. That's VOGA coffee.com. Today's episode is also brought to you by Espressly. Espressly creates beautiful, functional, branded mobile apps for your business. The experience that people have with your mobile app should be similar to the experience they have in your store. That's not always the case, though, but that's what Espressly provides you by combining the experience that they love about your brand with the convenience of mobile ordering, which is here to stay and something that I'm sure so many of us have explored for our businesses. It's a no-risk model. When you work with Espressly, there's no setup or development fees. You get drive-through payment scanners, receipt and label printing capabilities. It works with some of the world's best payment processing systems, stores the value in the app, and you get to keep all of the data. So this is a huge win for you if you're exploring mobile ordering for your business. Go find out more information and sign up today over at espressly.co. That's espressly.co. Okay, so today I wanted to talk to you about scaling values and why that is so critical to your business as you expand. So one of the things that I see happening often is that we assume that when we open a second or third location, that the values from the first one are going to transfer over. There's two mistakes there. One, we assume that people know what our values are in the current store. And two, we assume that transferring those types of things over to a second store is just naturally going to happen. Well, let's address the first thing here. Most people who work in a coffee bar don't really have much of an idea of what your values are past what they've read in manuals. If you have actions that back up your values, then maybe a lot of people will pick up on it. But even better, if you have actions that back up your values and you talk about your values often, and you make connections to your values in the daily work, and you allow your values to shape the work itself, then I think you're in a good place to make the assumption that people know what your values are. That wouldn't even be an assumption. That's just an observation at that point. So that's the first thing, is you have to make sure that what you've got currently is solid. It is you've taken the time to build it up to the place where you know people know the values. And not only do they know them, but they embody those values. You yourself as an owner embody those. And you can see in all of the small and big ways that your company runs, in at least store one, that these are values-based operations. And so if you've got that taken care of, you need to address the second thing, which is the assumption that you can simply open a second store and what you love about the store one will automatically transfer over. That is absolutely not the case. There's a lot of purposeful effort in transferring values from one store to the next when you scale. And mainly what I recommend people do is when you know that you've got at least a crew of people who are really good, they are, I guess what you would say, model employees, and at least they, more than anybody, embody the values that you love, the spirit of the organization, so to speak. I like to recommend that you take at least one or two of those people and help them be the cultural seed in the second store. They don't necessarily have to stay there the whole time. And of course, it's kind of up to them too. Like maybe it's too far away from their house or something like that. But as much as you can, take from the culture that you currently have, physically take from the culture, like the people who work in that store, and place them into the new store. It's almost like having a starter. You know how everyone's into sourdough, especially after the quarantine. Everyone nurses their sourdough starter. And that's similar to what you would need in store two. You need people who have taken on ownership of the values and the culture to be in that space, or else you're just going to be starting from scratch. And that might work, but at that point, you might as well have just opened a new business, because they might have heard about the values from the other store. They might have read about it in your manuals and whatnot. But just as much as you weren't able to communicate that in full until everyone experienced it in your first store, the second one's going to be the same. Unless you've got people there to walk the talk, to walk the values with you, especially when you're the owner and you're the maybe operations manager or somebody in charge of the project of the second store, you don't really have a lot of time to be that example to people in store two. So taking people from your first store that really represent the values and are great cultural examples, putting them in your second store, this is a great way to help that process along. So the last thing that I'm going to say about this, after we've addressed those first two things, making sure that we actually do have an identifiable culture that is being walked out in store one, and then essentially seeding the ground of the second store with people who have already been there, done that, walk the talk, and are going to just pass that on in practice to others. When you have those two things in place, it's going to go really well. So the last thing I'll say about scaling your values is something that I've said before about scaling your business. When you're talking about operations, we're talking about making sure that you have systems in place that support what you want to happen. More so than ever, it's important as you expand, because the first store, you could just go by word of mouth. In the second store, it needs to be codified a little bit more. Same thing goes for your values. So those also need to have systems attached to them, and you have to be more purposeful about how you communicate them. With the example that you give with your presence, how you communicate to the managers now in that space, it's going to be necessary, because you're not going to be able to be everywhere at the same time. And so you're going to have to start relying on systems and schedules a little bit more to support the communication and the walking out of values in the operations and the day-to-day work of the cafe. So with that, I hope that this episode was helpful for you. If you find yourself in that place of scaling and you have questions about how to bring continuity between the two stores or a few stores, I have found these things to be very helpful. I hope you have as well. Thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you here next week on another episode of Shift Break, From Keys to the Shop.